In this tutorial, I'm gonna explain how to draw a floor plan in AutoCAD. I explain how to draw, offset, trim and extend, and make boundaries using the layer properties. So let's dive in. Hello everyone, I'm Said Mandegar. This video is the first part of my new modern interior project. So stay with me till the end of this series. In next part you will see the final result. Anyway, first I check some must check as I do in every new document I create in AutoCAD, such as turning on or off the grids. I don't like it to be on, so I always turn it off, but it's on as AutoCAD default setting. Check all the different modes of a snap to be on. Type UN as units and set it on any parameters you use. I always use meters because we made anything based on meters measurement. Let me choose the right layer first. Choose line and start to draw by clicking in a specific direction. I prefer to set number to make an exact line length. I draw a rectangle and delete the line beneath. Choose offset command to stroke the exterior walls. Then I separate the inner rectangle lines using explode command, which needs to type X on your keyboard and press enter to apply that change. Let's make some inner lines to create interior spaces. Use repeat command via right click to use that command again. Now you see I'm just creating lines using offset command, but the final result will amaze you. To offset, all you need is to type the distance and click on the main line and then specify in which direction you need this offset to be drawn. Now I use trim command to cut the extra lines. Let's stretch it to make this wall a little longer. Totally, the most useful and practical commands in drawing a floor plans are line, trim, extend, offset, stretch, and these kind of commands. To trim, all you need is to select the trim and do one right click and then cut the extra lines. Thank you. divide, you have to type div or div first, then choose the lines and type the divide number and press enter or a space. Let's make a distance using offset command, then delete and trim the extra lines. I draw a line and move it a little up. Here will be our glass frame later in the modeling part. Again, drawing and trimming the lines to create the interior spaces. There should be a wall, so let's add a window here. now bedroom. There's a fillet in this corner of our room. Let's connect these two points and make an offset and delete the extra lines. As simple as that. I find the center point and draw a line, then offset in each side and delete the first in center. Let's break this line to make it a unique one. This window is very important. I'll make an awesome render around this window later. In layer properties, I create a new layer and name it BO as boundary. Choose a different color. Just wanted to show you how I create it. Now I delete it and use my previous one. Type boundary, select the pick points, and click inside each closed area. Notice that the area you're clicking inside must be closed by lines. Let's fix that by just moving it toward the wall lines. The problem is fixed. As simple as that. But sometimes it gives an error. Even there is no open point. All you need to do is to press enter to apply those boundaries and repeat this command for the left parts. You can also create some rectangle instead of using boundary in that specific layer you create as boundary. There's a trick to clear all extra lines. Notice that in this tutorial we want to export the boundary layer only. To do that, all you need is to turn off the main layer, here I mean the boundary layer, and delete or clear all other lines you see in your screen. Then turn on the boundary layer again, and now all you have is the boundary lines. You can also delete the other layers and leave the boundary layer available. Next, I will import this plan into 3ds Max and start modeling with one click. This is why I decided to draw floor plans as boundaries. You will be amazed by the next tutorial. Please like this video if it was helpful and subscribe to my channel if you need more. See you in next tutorial. Have fun!